Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's watch me work video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I created this beautiful purple Mylar set with some 3D artwork, so stay tuned for this video. So for this look, guys, I'm going to be linking everything in the description box down below for this look and what products I use, but I'm going to be using this really, really pretty deep purple dip powder. This is actually dip acrylic powder that I am using. I will link again in the description box. I'm going to go ahead and use this deep purple color, and I'm going to be using some pink and orange Mylar today, as well as Young Nails acrylic system in the color clear, and I'm going to be using their speed clear acrylic. They do have different curing times. I'm particularly going to be using the curing in 30 seconds, and I'm also going to be using the Nail Matrix acrylic brush in the size 8. I wanted to try out a new acrylic brush, so I'm going to definitely be mistake, that is actually a size 10. So I'm using a size 10 brush, but it's very similar to my size 8 Panna brush, in my opinion. I went ahead and I pinched it as well, because I like to work with pinch brushes. But here you can see me simply applying very thin layers of my clear acrylic, and then I'm applying my Mylar on top of it. I like to use a small brush when it comes to applying Mylar or when I'm doing my encapsulation. It's easier to control the product that is on the nail when I'm using a smaller brush. So again, I'm going to be using the Nail Matrix size 10 acrylic brush today, and it is pinched. And I'm also going to be using my size, so that brush that you see right there, guys, in my monomer, that again is Young Nails monomer, I'm using a size 10 brush for Panna. So I'm not really particularly sure if this is an acrylic brush by the Nail Matrix, but it is in the size 10. I'm not sure if it's a true 10, but I could be wrong. It could be an acrylic 3D brush that I'm using. But that brush that I'm using right there in my monomer is a 10, and I'm going to be using that brush right there for my encapsulation purposes. Putting my clear acrylic on top of this colored acrylic. So again, I like to go in with a small brush, particularly a size 8 acrylic brush. I like to use my Panna brushes, and I like to apply very thin layers of clear acrylic just so my product, whatever I'm encapsulating, can stick, adhere to the nail, but also not be too bulky. But again, with this Mylar, one thing I want to say with this Mylar, guys, when you are using Mylar and you're using a very pigmented acrylic color, if you want that Mylar to pop for its true color, you're going to want to make sure that the background is transparent. So that is one thing that I fell short on with this set, because the set is an actual inspiration set. But it turned out looking like a completely different set, and one of the reasons why is because the Mylar did not pop to true color like we had wanted it to. So definitely take note of that when you are working with Mylar. You want to make sure that the background is very transparent. What they be doing to you?
Everything.
Okay, then that's probably why you mean to them. I be telling people the same. Don't be mean to me, and we won't see mean me.
But I think I have an aggressive personality in a sense sometimes. Like,
I haven't seen it.
I think sometimes I just be like, look.
Fed up with stuff?
Yeah. I don't be putting up with a lot of shit, so I think that's what it is. I don't have patience for shit, so like, people be like, girl, you, I mean as fuck, and I be like, no, like, this is how I feel, for real. I do be mean to though. I don't see why they like me, because I be mean as fuck.
Maybe because you mean.
They be loving that shit. I be like, I don't know why, because I be like, mean as hell. Well, I guess my friends tell me I'm not mean enough to these people. That could be a possibility too, shit.
Not mean enough.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm not, like.
What you mean they be saying anything? Like disrespectful?
Yeah. Kind of, sort of, like. The other day, I went to the store and this was like, you look like you want. Well, nah, he like, you walking like you want somebody to put a baby in you. I was like, huh?
Huh? Who just randomly? That's a Chicago thing. That's a Chicago thing. I think men don't be understanding that they harassing women out here.
Listen, I was like, what does that even mean? He was like, you got that walk. You just walking like you want somebody to put a baby in you. I'm like, all right. He's like, it might be me. I was like,
bye.
Then somebody else was like, it was an old man. He was like, yo, stop some traffic, girl. I was ooh. Like, ooh.
An old man?
Mm-hmm. Then it was a group of old men that I walked by, and they was like, ooh, shit. God damn.
I hate
like,
the old
loud
ones.
As hell. I'm like, oh, my
old
God.
Old ones be the worst because they don't give a fuck no more.
No, they don't. They really don't. So they just be saying anything, and I was like, y'all don't care about how I might feel about y'all catcalling me, but all right, whatever.
Okay, guys, so now I'm going to get into the encapsulation part of this video. So I'm going in with Young Nails Clear Acrylic. This is their 30-second cure. For this particular encapsulation, I'm going to still stick with my 3-bead method since I didn't apply a lot of Mylar to this nail. I only applied a thin sheet of Mylar, very, very thin. But one thing about Mylar when it comes to encapsulation, sometimes like the Mylar, excuse me, will like lift if it's not glued. So sometimes I will have to go in with a little bit more acrylic just to fill in the areas that the acrylic couldn't get to. I'll either file that down with my actual file, or sometimes like depending on the Mylar, I might actually have to drill off that little piece of Mylar that's stuck through. But this is my traditional method of applying acrylic, is my 3-bead method. Depending on what I am doing for artwork, again, my method of application does change. But for encapsulation for this particular style, I went ahead and stuck with my 3-bead method. I applied my first very thin layer of colored acrylic. A lot of people do tell you to encapsulate with a thin layer of clear, and then you go in with your color and then all of the other good shenanigans and stuff. But for me personally, I know how my client is, she's going to soak off her nails. So I didn't have to worry about that. So I just went ahead and applied that really thin layer of colored acrylic. I made sure to prime, dehydrate, put the color, put the Mylar, and now I'm going in with my 3-bead method. And then of course I'm going to go ahead and fill in any areas. So after I filed, I buffed, I 3-way buffed, excuse me. I went ahead and I did my acrylic painting artwork. You guys can do this simple design with just white acrylic paint. I did a two-line design with the acrylic paint. I'll do a demo video for you guys here on YouTube. This is a really, really easy design to do with acrylic paint. I do usually have my acrylic paint on my Patreon, but this is a very simple, easy to do style with acrylic paint, so it's definitely going to be YouTube worthy. So I'll definitely post a demo video showing you guys how to do this this line work. For this acrylic paint, I simply went in with a consistency that was a little bit more watery. So I had more medium mixed into my acrylic paint, and then I had the correct ratio for the more pigmented white that you see overlapping on top of the thinner paint, just to give that like butterfly ray, lightning bolt effect. That's what I really wanted to go for this look. So now you can see I'm simply applying a very small bead of acrylic for these 3D flowers. These 3D flowers are from Chi Chi. I will definitely link her Instagram name and everything in the description box below. She sent me these really, really pretty charms 2 months ago just to try out, and I've fallen in love with them. I'm going to actually place my first order with her for some more of these charms. These are amazing. I love charms a lot now, and so do my clients. So simply what I am doing here is I'm simply applying the acrylic to her nail, and then I'm going in and applying the butterfly on top of that. One thing that I also did prior to applying the acrylic on top of the top coat is I went in with my drill and I made some of the gel come off of the nail, excuse me. You can't apply smooth to smooth. So acrylic is smooth. You don't want to apply smooth acrylic on top of your gel top coat for the 3D charm because it's simply going to pop off. So I wanted to make a rough surface, excuse me, make a rough surface on top of my top coat, go in with my acrylic. Sometimes I do use hard gel, but for this video, I went ahead with my acrylic. And then you simply place a little small bead of acrylic, place your artwork, your 3D charm on top of it, and then you're good to go. So once I'm done completely with this set, I'm going to go in with my cuticle oil that I personally like to make for my clients. This has a coconut pineapple scent to it. I go in with a lot of different vitamins and different oils for my cuticle oils, but I like to go ahead and go around the entire cuticle with my cuticle brush, and then I like to rub it into my clients' cuticles. That's why my cuticles always look really, really dry before I go into this part right here. When I'm doing my acrylic painting, the fingers are still completely dry, the cuticles are still dry, but this is my favorite part, is the cuticle area. I rub in that cuticle oil, and I always tell my clients to always freshen up just to make their sets look brand new, and also to help soften up, excuse me, that dry cuticle skin that does happen to really form in the fall and winter time. I've noticed here in Chicago, cuticles get really, really dry. So this is the final look, guys, after I'm done with the cuticles. I really love how this look came out. If I were to redo this look a different time, I would definitely use more mylar. I probably would do more layers and things like that, but I definitely love, love, love this set. Definitely make sure you give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video.